But how do you pick the right bottle of wine to give at this time of year? Well, for that, we turn to Michael Perry, who is from the tasting room manager from our Lodi Wine and Visitor Center. Good morning to you. Happy holidays to you.
Good morning. Happy holidays to you as
well.
You
know, so many times it's obligatory. You walk in, you hand a bottle of wine, and you say thanks, but how do you know which is the right bottle to give?
Well, the good news is wine is always a good gift, regardless of what you're giving. So we can always have that comfort level that when we select a bottle of wine, we're going to hand it over to somebody. It's wine. They're going to take it in the right way. So we have that confidence. But having said that, we always want to try and give the right wine. So I ask people a question, and I would pose a question to you. Is this person that we're giving wine to a wine consumer?
Yeah, that's a good point. The other thing I often wonder is, do you take a bottle of wine for the evening to drink that night or to give for them to enjoy later?
And that's going to be the consumer's call. That's a question I would ask. But let's for the sake of argument, say we don't know anything other than this person drinks wine on a regular basis. Mm-hmm. That limits us, in my way of thinking, to red wines. So I would probably take the white wines because most people who drink wines on a regular basis and drink reds like them because they're complex and interesting mm-hmm. and ever-changing.
So you're probably safer with red than you are white.
I think you're safer as a gift for a wine person okay. with reds and whites. Doesn't mean wines aren't great gifts or whites mm-hmm. aren't great gifts, but I think reds are safer.
So what about these bottles led you to make them some of your top picks this year?
Well, I'm going to interrupt. I like this one. This thing is more in it. This thing is huge. This bottle's huge.
Actually, it's just a bigger bottle, but same volume.
Okay.
What I did with these two bottles, I also ask when people come into our taste room, do you have a price range in mind? Because a lot of people equate quality with price. I don't necessarily, but sometimes that's important to people, so we want to have a price range.
You may not, but we did a story recently about a survey where it showed that like 3 out of 4 people do.
Exactly. So I tried to give you two options here. When we're giving a gift to someone who's a wine consumer, I think you want to stay away from the lower priced wines simply because of the style. They're usually lighter and simpler. And again, if somebody drinks a lot of wine like this, they're used to more complex styles. So I've given you a medium price point and what we would call a premium price point.
So for example?
Medium, anywhere from $18 to $20 a bottle. Premium and Lodi, for Lodi wines, anywhere from, say, $30 to $40, up as high as $60 a bottle of wine.
Okay.
So that gives you, as the person coming into my room, a little bit of flexibility mm-hmm. with where you want to go. But in either case, and we're talking Zinfandels here because Lodi is, of course, known for great Zinfandels, in either case, we have complex wines that are interesting and would be great gifts, whether it be for dinner or just as a gift.
Sometimes little wine accessories like this little, what do you call it, a pour decanter? I don't know.
This is an aerator.
An aerator.
And there's a lot of different names and things that are given to these things, but this is probably one of the hottest gadgets in the wine world right now. And basically, as a lot of wine consumers know, you like to try and get air into wine just to release the aromas. This does it as it's actually leaving the bottle and going into the glass, and there's a little mechanism on top that kind of percolates the wine.
So you pour it. That's what I can describe.
Yeah, I can actually demonstrate this for you if you like.
Please do.
So I don't know how well you can catch this, but you can see the little bit of percolating action here in the top, and this will open the wine up a little bit, and I've done this where I've poured wine directly into a glass without this, and then this in the glass next to it with the pour, and there is a significant difference.
And that might
difference.
Be just something that's kind of fun to do at the party that you're going to that night. It might be something that your host might not normally have splurged on.
This might be a great
a
gift for that wine consumer, no
yeah.
question
Michael,
about it.
Michael, thank you very much. We appreciate it. Great tips for us, rather, from the Lodi Wine and Visitor Center.